2 weeks ago, residents of Kitikobirongo were left in shock after silence opened fire on a city lawyer, Ronald Mukisa, 45 years, and killed him instantly. In the latest development, the Joint Security Forces managed to arrest four suspects. Among them is Kampala Metropolitan North Deputy Police Commander, Superintendent of Police Vincent Iroma.
So the four suspects whom we've so far arrested and are highly linked to the murder include Karedu Robert Iroma, is a businessman, and his wife Naroga Brenda Kathy. We have Popolo Anyuse Max Geoffrey, a UPDF deserter. He deserted from the 1st Battalion, Operation Shuja.
According to preliminary findings, SP Iroma hired out his gun to Corporal Max Geoffrey Anyuse, a UPDF deserter who trailed Ronald Mukisa and shot him several times at his home in Birongo.
The four bullets killed the victim instantly, and we've established that as Corporal Anyuse got away on a waiting motorcycle, he called Naroga Brenda and informed her how they had accomplished the mission.
Enanga explains that investigations by security indicate that the deceased legal officer had a number of business dealings with one Ronald Karedu and his wife Brenda Naruoga, and the three were known to each other. However, the trio fell out over a deal gone bad. Karedu and his wife plotted to kill the legal officer, and since they were known to SP Iroma, he agreed to give out the gun for the mission.
We do strongly condemn in the strongest terms the actions of the two officers who, instead of protecting the lives of Ugandans, willfully took the desire to take another human's life for money. So there is no place for such kinds of gross indiscipline, barbaric and aggressive behavior in the forces. And for that, we want to inform the public that the actions of the two officers are regrettable and are not representative of the two disciplined forces, the Uganda Police and the Uganda People's Defense Forces.
Karedu and his wife, Naruoga, have since been arrested, and two AK-47 magazines with 56 rounds of ammunition recovered from their home in Kulambiro. At SP Iroma's home, a gun and a pistol with several rounds of ammunition were also recovered. These have been taken to the forensic labs for ballistic examination.
So which means that if two magazines usually carry 60 ammunition, so if they were full, that means 8 bullets were missing. We got military uniforms, among others, and a brief interrogation. Popular News admitted to having shot the victim.
Meanwhile, police officers who participated in the raid on Sheikh Yunus Kamoga's home have been suspended for gross indiscipline. This follows a complaint from the Muslim Lawyers Association that a number of Sheikh Kamoga's family members were assaulted by the police officers during the raid. Sheikh Kamoga's home was raided by security officers on allegations that the Muslim cleric was involved in illegal Islamic education. However, CCTV footage shown by family shows police officers assaulting the occupants of a home.
That 13 officers who participated in the raid have been suspended, and they are scheduled to appear before the disciplinary court. They also remain under investigation for torture and aggressive behavior, pending retrieval of the medical forms that we issued to the victims.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.